The talk is called "Can Your Site Work on IE3?" Okay. Must have some background. What is the next slide?
Next.
So Kheng Meng is my friend. He's my friend who fly aeroplane. And then when he when he was telling everybody how he become a pilot to fly aeroplane, in a March edition or Head and Tail. Was it? No, huh? It was before that, huh? Before. Before he started talking about aeroplanes, we somehow got to the topic of like use IE3. So this screenshot very blur, but okay, we will recreate the conversation. Okay, he say, yeah.
Oh, you want to use IE3 or you want IE5?
I said, I want 3, because IE5 very advanced now in terms of support and stability. So Kheng Meng say he never expected to hear the words IE5 very advanced. So some history between the two of us, huh? If you ever show up for this event called Super City Hackathon, it's a very entertaining event. Happens end of the year, where if the organizers feel like doing it. First edition happened December 2017. Then we were one team. Our team is called Team 486. There's no other reason, no auspicious reason other than 486 is the processor name, Team 486. So what did we do?
Okay, so this is what we did. You can see the screenshot on the right. Yeah, so we install Linux on that, we host a web page on it and made it play music. And know that it's a 486 PC, it's not a modern PC. Right. Yeah, so yeah, this is how we work together. So we decide to work together again.
Yeah.
For this one.
So we specialize in retro computing, correct? So, what is Internet Explorer 3? If you don't know what is Internet Explorer 3, either you not born yet in 1996, I born already. At the time, I was 9 years old, correct? Everybody know. Okay, anyway, Internet Explorer 3 is very interesting because it's the first commercial browser to support CSS. I think that is where this whole, that's where this discussion, like, hey, can you see IE5? Like, no. 3. IE3 not supported in a lot of OSs. Windows 3.1, 95, and so you cannot anyhowly install, must have a Windows 3.1 computer. And I already knew him from a few years ago because in a very long time ago, Hackware, he presented his installation of Windows 3.1. So confirm chop, he got genuine 3.1. So I was like, hey, you help me install IE3. Then we do funny things. So he will talk to you in case you have not used Windows 3.1, it's like one of the best OSs ever. But in case you're not born, explain.
Okay. Not my turn. Okay, let me take this. Yeah. Okay. So what is this Windows 3.1, right? Actually, I'm just curious, how many of you have used Windows 3.1 before? Well, that's a very big audience. Okay. But I think at least half of you, but still minority. Only minority of you use it before. Okay, so I'll talk about what is this. Okay, not blocking. So it's one of the first series of 16-bit OS. I mean, y'all heard of 32-bit and 64-bit OS, right? Y'all never think about what is before that, right? Yeah, Windows 3.1 is what is before that. Before things like Windows 95. Okay, so the first version of Windows 3.1 released on, like you see, 1992. Right, but this particular version I'm using is called Windows for Workgroups. It's a later variant that has internet network access. So Windows for Workgroups, right, is the first Windows OS to have inbuilt network access. Wow, very long, right? Okay, and the thing about Windows 3.1, right, is all of them require DOS to be installed first. Okay, so Windows 3.1 technically is not an operating system. DOS is an operating system. Windows 3.1 is just an application that runs on DOS. Right, yeah. That was the early days of Windows. Okay, you can see I created a rough timeline, okay? So what came first? Definitely DOS came first, right? So DOS, the first one released 1981. Then you can see when was Windows 3.1 released? This time, around 1992, 1993, around this time, right? So you can trace back, you know. Finally, where's Windows 10? Right here, you know. So how far back this is? Yeah, really long time ago. Okay, start a quick demo first?
Wait, explain some context.
Oh, okay.
In case it's not obvious, this presentation is running on Windows 3.1 PowerPoint semi version.
PowerPoint 4.
This is PowerPoint 4. This legit. Later, escape. This This is Windows 3.1. It's not fake, huh? Everybody, this is
real. If I memorize PowerPoint 4. Yeah, 4, correct.
You hear that thing, legit original one, okay? Cannot recreate, it's not chiong one, it's real one. Okay, so the demo is that I anyhowly build a site, then I don't want to test on the machine because, you know, I just feel like it. So he has seen it, I have not seen it. It might look like shit. So he's gonna open it.
The network haven't down yet. Yeah, Google works, okay.
Google works on HTTP. HTTP 1.0.
Yeah.
Okay. So Google is probably one of the only websites that still runs on like the original base protocol.
So I run the IE3 challenge.
Yeah, okay. Wow, you bookmark so professional. First of all, I would like to cue everybody to this lovely ambient background music because Internet Explorer implemented something called BG sound. It's non-standard, but they implemented it anyway, and it allows people to play irritating music on an infinite loop. I think that's why it was never standardized. So clearly it looks like shit, cause Huijing never test. So yeah. But never mind, cause there are two more browsers here that apparently look better. So clearly it looks like shit. Yeah. So this is clearly a failed experiment, but on the plus side, try Netscape. Netscape don't have sound because only VG sound only supported in Internet Explorer. But later I will explain why building it. But later I can explain to you why building blind for IE3 is so hard. Because even though IE3 says that we support CSS. Support is a very subjective term, turns out. Because, for example, things like width, not supported. Things like background color, not supported. Padding, not supported. Single what? Border, not supported. Okay. Netscape looks a bit better. Wrong one. Okay. Netscape seems to like 有一点 structure, but still looks like shit. So at this point in time, the browsers didn't really implement CSS properly at all. They spec, but the browsers don't follow the spec. They're just like, what is this spec thing? Then we do our own thing. Because IE and Netscape were doing their browser war shit. So they all siao liao.
If cannot, I need to restart.
So okay, while he restart, then I can gong gong su. So during the time was when browsers tried to differentiate themselves by types of feature support. So actually, if you can remember, you got see those buttons that say, works best in Netscape Navigator, works best in Internet Explorer. It's like the worst. Okay, so Opera, right, is actually among all the browsers had implemented, because you had to implement CSS first. And one of your browsers was the first implementation. So 3.62 is the best first implementation of CSS at the time. And so this is built blind, and clearly it looks much better on Opera than like IE3, where it looks like shit. But the 重点 is, can we pipe the new one? Yeah, pipe the new. You want to finish, you finish first.
Okay, can.
The same code base will work in a modern browser. Later you see.
Did y'all notice that I close the browsers like before I open the next browser, right? I didn't go and run it all simultaneously, right? Yeah, it's a deliberate one because of the RAM.
How much RAM?
I'll come to that. Yeah. So my slides. So my alternate tab. Let's go back to my slides.
Alternate tab works.
Yeah, alternate tab works. Yeah, then PowerPoint works, you know.
Next time you need to give presentation, consider using PowerPoint 4. Very piece of software.
See, so now she asked, right, everything asked, right, what is the spec of this PC, right? Come on, I can see, it is a Pentium 2 PC, you know, it released in 1999. Okay, so I need to qualify this. A Pentium 2 PC is very advanced for a Windows 3.1 computer. Mm. Okay, but this just happens that this is one of the last PCs to have a Windows 3.1 drivers. So I decided to give this presentation the best possible chance. Run the most powerful PC that Windows 3.1 still has support for. Okay. You can see the RAM 384 meg, but the Windows 3.1 only recognize 256. right? So this extra is a bit useless. Then parallel 88 hard drive. I did not use a normal hard drive. This is a compact flash card. Oh, I'm not talking. I'm actually down. Okay, so there's a compact flash card adapter because this kind of hard drive a bit hard to find these days really, and they are not reliable. Okay, it has a CD-ROM drive. Yeah, CD-ROM drive. There. In case you don't forget what a CD-ROM, I don't think you see your era, right? CD-ROM or CD4, right? Yeah, but this one, this one is another one. Yeah, this one has a floppy disk drive, you know. See, I put here. Imagine a laptop with a floppy disk drive. Eh? Wow. Okay, so it has serial port, parallel port, VS2 port. That's how I use my mouse. USB, it has USB 1.0. This was one of the first PCs to have for a laptop, to a USB 1 port only. Infrared, you know. And it has two card bus slots, so can possible to expand on. Okay, see the price of this laptop. When you try to buy that time, like $2,700 USD, right? Correct for inflation today is $5,600. This kind of price, normally is gaming laptop grade. Today, this one I buy second hand. I think $200 or less. Okay, so how did I get this such an old OS, right? You can actually go to this website called WinWorld PC, you can find the old images. And then, problem is these images come in floppy disk images. So you see how many floppy disks I use, you know? Like, one by one, burn the image in, then install next disk, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's your 6. So the Windows 3.1 has 6. 8. 8S, 8X. Okay? Yeah, this is just extra note. Mac OS, El Capitan onwards don't support floppy drive anymore. So I had to use a Windows PC and burn the image in. Hey, why? I see what it's like. Let me skip. Okay, so you may ask, how did I get network connection, right? It's very rare PCs this old got network connection, but this one can. So the first attempt, right, I use is the card bus adapter. So this is an expansion card, typical for laptops of that era. So you put a card inside, you get network access, but this one, they don't, for some reason, the DOS drivers don't work. So I don't have a choice. I go to my backup plan, which is this one. So this is called a parallel port network adapter. Y'all don't know what is a parallel port, right? I don't think y'all still remember what is that. A parallel port is a port that is this. I can't plug it out now, but after this presentation, y'all see. Convert out to a LAN, to Ethernet. But Ethernet, nowadays people don't use that often. So you need to convert the Wi-Fi, right? So it goes to this one. It's a wireless Ethernet bridge. Then for wireless Ethernet bridge, what happened then? Go to my iPad, iPad tethering. So one jump, then finally, okay, yeah, I get internet access on this PC. Okay, wait. So let me show you the network configuration. Okay. So Windows setup, click. Okay, let me go change network settings. Okay, you can see here, right? It has TCP IP inside. Open, click setup. See, yeah, I have automatic DHCP. But the problem is the DNS, right, on this old PC, right, need to be manually set. I can set a modern DNS server, okay? 1.1.1.1. Yeah, it works. Okay. Let me close one by one by one. Wait. Right, you all run ipconfig, right? You know ipconfig is that old? ipconfig exists this far back. Yeah. Then why not just show something else? Like RGDIT. Okay. Not here. Never mind. Because this DOS ROM is a true DOS ROM. Okay, back. Where? I think that's... Oh. Do I have any more slides? I don't think I can go to the end. Yeah, we see it's very, very slow. Yeah. I think that's already, yes. Yeah, so that's all for my section on how I managed to get IE3 to
hardware done,
yes. Yeah, so now it's back to Huijing's turn. Switch to two.
Sorry to engineers though, actually.
No,
keep going.
Wait, how come this one
is there? Just now
K1. You lower your resolution 7.3.
Done. I'm screwing things up.
No, it's transparent to you. So, I have a laptop here.
Oh, my computer hangs here.
Oh, end up the enhanced computer hang.
The
only computer still alive.
Eh, really? Eh, 真的 hang 掉了 eh. Can reboot. Is this computer is doing what?
Just taking the input.
Oh, cannot use. Okay, can.
But
I
cannot see
the screen. Yeah. Okay, can. Yes. Computer hang. Eh.
No, I expected this one to hang.
I know, right? Clearly, modern PC not doing very well. So anyway, the point is that the code base for both the shitty IE3 site and the modern browser that I'm attempting to boot, it uses the same, it's like the same code and the same CSS lah. Then it looks better on the modern browser, I like to think, if my computer can boot up. And so I was talking to Hong Kheng earlier, and she was like, hey, use table lah. It's like, can use table, but if you use table, huh, then when you do the modern browser at time, right, then the markup very kana sai. Then like you really can't really, but you are very stuck, because I'm going to run through why I say that supports CSS is such a subjective term. This is my office computer trying to activate all the spyware used to monitor employees. So it will take about like three minutes or so. They have to like, oh yeah, let's see if she's working. Then maybe they're using the camera. You can play the ambient music, but this is gonna take 3 minutes, guys. This is how long it takes for me to boot up. This is why I don't reboot my computer. Okay, like if you are listening next month, please continue pay my CPF. Don't fire me, thanks. Yeah, but he can show you the source code. It's actually quite nicely formatted. So I'm trying not to use any tables because it's going to affect the modern browser implementation if I use too many tables. But I did use a few tables for the sake of it lah, to see if I can hack the table to modernize. What is this updating manage setting? Ayo. Next one, don't fire me. I shut down my computer because... No, I... You, okay, fine. You have a problem. Cancel. So... What you want me to do? I don't want to live updates, yeah. What? How much? 720, huh? 720. Okay, everybody can see my shitty computer. Yeah. Scale. Correct? Wrong? Correct?
Is it okay?
I think so.
Okay, can.
Okay. Okay, let me type my Firefox. Oh, I really want to show the shitty one, man. It's so shitty. IE3. Look at this. Then this one's not supposed to be an image. This one actually is text,
right?
Yeah. No, this is text. This is supposed to be text.
Oh, really?
Oh. It's CSS, mah. Then the like yeah, you can like the you can do your what you call list style to be a bit shit. Yeah. Then. Oh, cause my resolution. Okay, never mind. I think if I zoom out, it looks better. Yeah, something like that. Okay, so the important part is this article that says it's reference material for those of you who would like to build your own website for IE3. But they are notes. They are very important notes. So one of the things is. Here, it says things like go down. Even though class as a selector purported to be supported is not. Trust me, I tried. ID cannot, not supported, never mind. Contextual selectors kind of, so you can say like P span something. But there's a very limited number of permutation and combination if you don't get to use classes. So that's that. Well, at least at the time, you cannot anyhowly important, so maybe that's a good thing. The best part is, Internet Explorer 3 seems altogether incapable of cascading. So it should be called CS, not CSS. Actually, don't know, it should be called SS, just style sheets don't want the C. Because cannot cascade, then why you call CSS? Right? Like, wow, kena cheats, yeah? And then, blah blah blah, margins not inherited. Wait, there's a longer. This one. So, blah blah blah. There are bugs and limitations. So, missing functionality. Margin and margin bottom are both not supported. Padding, not supported. Border, not supported. Still got what? Like? Left margin of body and P elements do not add up. What do you mean? Margins do not collapse as described. Okay, fine, never mind. In order for all lists to be aligned, they must be within an explicit P element. Sure. You cannot set styles or implied tags. So if you do not include a body tag in your document, anything attached to a body element, no effect. Okay, also can. Line spacing is added to the last line of a formatted element. That is why there's so much space around the headlines. And, oh, this one also very good. Vertical spacing sometimes act weird after list. So, if you build blind, you cannot. You can try. But the best part is, that's how we found out that Opera actually is the best implementation because... Oh, I didn't include the article. There was this article that explained. Oh no. Go back to this one. This is a list of all the properties that are supposed to be in CSS 1, but then they tell you whether IE3 support or not. So okay, got font family, right, sure. Font style, okay, all this not important, never mind, moving on. Color, yes. Background color, no. Everything, all no. Cannot, no, nothing. Moving on. Here also got background are not applied correctly to element except for body TD and T. Ayo, what is this? TD and TH. Then this is why everybody still use table. Not use P, I cannot. Use div, I cannot. Then values for background position are applied only to the body element. Okay, can. The last two is fake news because I tried to do background image, all cannot. So fake news. All this, all cannot. So you put there, also got put equal no put. Even though it says yes, just now the bug say margin not supported. Padding, no padding, so that's fine. No borders, also never mind. Continue on, still got what? Basically everything is no lah, huh? Width not supported leh. How to do? Tell me how to do. Height also not supported, float also not supported. Then display not supported. That's the best one, display not supported. Why display none also cannot? So basically, it's a very long list of no's. So it's very exciting to build this website. That's why I took the effort to go and zeng the modern one to zeng nice a bit. But the original one, I think my crowning achievement for IE3 was the VG sound tag. So just we know that the VG sound tag confirmed work. So if you want to look at my horrible code, okay. Can. The sound will be like a heartbeat to make sure that the computer never crash. Correct. Lie. I think my computer hung again. Yeah, my computer is hanging. Okay, clearly my computer doesn't work anymore, so it doesn't let me show the code because it's hung. It has hung. Cannot now. Yeah, use yours. I know my computer can, but hang already.
Where's your phone?
You give up?
What's your handle? GitHub handle?
Huijing. Actually can eh. But you cannot see the CSS.
Okay.
What? I plug.
Where's your laptop? The.
So?
Oh, for there.
So the code looks like this. Zoom. Control full screen.
You don't need to show this one.
Don't need. Play music can now.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so to make the original IE3 black background, unfortunately cannot be in the external one. It has to be here. Otherwise it doesn't work. So you have to put, if you want the background to be any other color, you have to put in a style tag on the HTML. Somehow the rest still works, so go back. Okay. So this is the as basic as it will go. This width 100% is pointless, so it doesn't take on IE3, but it probably took on Opera, so the Opera looks better. Yeah. The name CSS colors actually work, but at the time there were not 140, I think there was like 12 maybe. This was my attempt to hide the actual text, because the real one, I'll show you the code later, is so actually very very pathetic set of styles, to be honest. Cause on the IE3 one, the titles are actually images. So you can see this one. This is the image. But because modern browsers, I can use class, so I can display none. Oh my god. Cause you cannot, I couldn't do it the other way around. So normally you do it the other way around, right? So never mind. So what you do, you hack it with display contents. Why display contents? It was because of the tables. Cause the table nested too deep already. So hack this. Table and t-body become contents. So you like get rid of it. This is very non-standard, because display content shouldn't be used at all right now due to some is browser bugs, but they never fix it. There's a very big accessibility concern where if you use display contents, it disappears from the accessibility tree altogether. So don't do this at home, kids. But after that, then you can get your TR to be your parent, so you can do display flex and do all kind of funny things, and then you can also have like. It's not important. Moving on, blah blah blah. The background is, where's my background? Show the side again. Hey, why you always Chrome? Don't Chrome leh. You got Firefox not?
I think so. Not sure.
Never mind.
Use Chrome lah.
Don't want.
I'm not a web developer.
Don't want. Firefox. Very good. Use Firefox, friends. This talk was not sponsored by Mozilla. Anyway, yeah, so this funny background, okay, this... Is this an image? This is not an image, right? If I cannot right-click. How to right-click? Bro.
No, right-click is there.
Bottom right-click. Oh, like that? Okay, yay, got... Yeah, got inspector 是很好的事情. Okay, come. Let's see. This is text lah. This one not play cheat one lah. This one really is text lah. It's not an image. On IE3 it was an image. But this is text. Then so if you have question about mixed blend mode, please ask this lady's thing right here in front, cause she's the mixed blend mode expert. But actually the back got this image, and then you overlay, and then you blend mode, and then become like that. So pattern zui zui la, right, okay? Then... So all this is fine, because these are like regular divs. But the... Yeah, why did I turn it off? Div... Section, things like section, things like main, on IE3 is totally not recognized. But you can still put it there. The browser just don't care. So that's fine. What was not fine was that the browser didn't care about classes. So that was a bit tricky. But the rest of this is okay. So this background, this funny background, is also CSS, it's also not an image. So if I click here, you can see this ridiculous code that is done with linear gradient, blah blah blah. Then you background size and then you tile. Can, very normal. Also use viewport unit, so it's like nicely one viewport. Yeah. This one is actually cheating, because you can't actually use emoji as this style image, because it's an emoji, it's not an image. But if you had a nice icon in an image file, you can do this. This specifically is just pseudo element, yeah, sadly. So you just add content, but you can either do the, so you can sort of customize the style depending on the style. This is grid. You can animate things like altogether incapable of cascading. This is amazing to me, so I must highlight it because it's so amazing. Yeah, so you can also change to other things if you want to do funny these styles. And yeah, lor, like that lor. So if you want to build something for IE3 but still make it look nice in a modern browser, it's possible. You have to think a lot about the markup. So you cannot just anyhowly say, oh yeah, F this, I just use table. Because if you just F this, use tables, when it comes to the modern browser, then it's very hard. So you have to either live with the limitations of IE3 not supporting anything at all, or shitty markup. So it's like, so I went with the IE3 being shit and then use the proper markup. So yeah, this is the boliao kind of thing that I do. Then yeah, thanks for coming. Thanks for supporting CSS instead of React. I genuinely appreciate all of you. Now I know you're all OT come. So if I start at 7:30, you'll probably show up about 8. I know this about you now, which is great. Do whatever you want. Come late, also never mind. If you come, then good lah. If you don't come, also never mind. We got like video. Cause according to Kheng Meng, got video, got talk.
Yes.
Got video, got talk. So I'm gonna put that.
Videos that so happen.
Yeah. If there's video, means it's got meet up. So you never come, you can claim that you will watch the video, even though I know you all won't. So anyway, thank you all for coming. Appreciate this. Next time we got meet up, I will double check that we don't clash with React.js. So one last thing is a few standard announcements. First of all, anyone got announcement or not? You need to hire cat sitter, you need to look for a confinement lady, you looking for a job, you looking to hire, got or not? Got or not? Like, come. Can stop already, this is nonsense now.